iPadOS just changed the game again. This year, iPad unapologetically stole WWDC with a list of features that power users have lusted over for years, making it that low-key laptop replacement that some of you, myself included, have been side-eyeing for a while now. But here is the twist. It's not just about what is new, it is about what is finally possible with the iPad. So let's talk about how iPadOS 26 might finally let your iPad replace your Mac. Starting with the Glowup, Apple is rolling out a full visual redesign of all its platforms, and it's called Liquid Glass. You'll notice that the second that you unlock or lock your screen, the animations are smoother, the transitions are more fluid, and the whole thing feels more intentional. Apple even tweaked the unlock flow on devices like the iPad Air, where you swipe up first before being prompted for your unlock credentials. And I saw something on Threads that this might be like a precursor to how Apple glasses will function with a swipe up for the gestures to make it feel more natural, because you'd be able to look through glasses before being prompted for any type of credentials. Whether it's true or not, it's definitely faster, cleaner, and more consistent of an experience. But the real glow up, it is that transition layers are everywhere. The taskbar, the home screen. Even your apps shimmer in a way that reacts to your wallpaper and the environment behind it. There are even new customizations that allow you to adjust app transparency. You couple different modes. Instead of just light and dark mode, you can have a clear light mode and then a clear dark mode, really giving you a much more personal feel on your iPad than you had before. Now, it's really cool the way that Liquid Glass is refracting light and interacts with your on-screen content in a way that's whimsical and making the iPad very fun to use. Now, honestly, at first I was like, I don't know if I like this, but after a day, I've been a convert. I think that Liquid Glass looks really good on the iPhone. It looks great on the iPad, but you let me know what you think. Now, there was a slight kind of moment of readability for me personally, but it's not perfect. But remember, this is just the first look at the developer beta, and I'm confident that it'll look even better by the time it officially releases in the fall. It's subtle, it's put together, and makes the iPad feel more premium and more alive than ever before. Next up, we have several quality of life improvements that will not only streamline your work, but they will make working on your iPad more fun, and nothing says fun like input controls, people. That's right, the old round blob is gone, and in its place, we have proper arrow support in 2025, iPadOS 2025. It is sharp, it is more precise, and it feels way more like using a Mac. Now, you're gonna notice this instantly when hovering over text, buttons, and interface elements. It's gonna tie everything together, and it pulls forward the idea of desktop class features on the iPad. Now, speaking of desktop class features on the iPad, the menu bar is now available system-wide. A menu bar on the iPad. I just can't believe it. You can tap on the app name in the top left-hand corner like you can on the Mac. You can press Command 1 to jump straight into the app's menu settings. It is fast, it is intuitive, and it feels like a real improvement to the iPad. But not everything has made the cut, folks. Remember that handy shortcut when you held on the Command key and you'd see all the available list of all your keyboard shortcuts on screen? Well, that is gone. It is 86th. It died with iPadOS 18. I think it's a bug. Hopefully it's not a feature, but either way, I think this will be the most Mac-like change coming to iPadOS this year. And by the way, if you want a real-world preview of the public beta when it drops, I'll be covering everything from the moment it goes live. So if that sounds like something that you want to see, make sure you are subscribed and hit that bell, because you don't want to miss it. All right, let's talk apps, because iPadOS 26 brings a handful of long-awaited changes to the iPad and one major upgrade to an app that you probably use every day. I guess it really depends on how old you are, but we'll talk about that in a minute. First change is going to be Preview. This app is long-awaited because you can use Preview to open up PDFs, mark up images, and quickly annotate documents, all without needing a third-party tool. Then there's the Journal app. It launched on the iPhone 2 years ago now, but on the iPad, it feels way more natural. You get a larger canvas, you get full Apple Pencil support, and just a better layout. Now, since the Journal app uses suggestions from your iPhone based on who you come in contact with, who you are with, location photos, you can choose to sync those journaling suggestions to the iPad or not. It is totally your call, but I love the Journal app because it allows me just to get something out of my head and write it down real quick, and it just feels more natural when you are writing it down. I think that the biggest change coming to the iPad is the Files app. It is full-on upgrade season for the iPad in iPadOS 26 with the Files app, because you can now set preferences for different file types. You can mark folders as favorites, pin them to the dock, as well as customize how they look using the new Customize Folder and Tags contextual menu option. Now, tag colors apply to the folder, so if I have like a tag for important, that folder is gonna be that color. And it's kind of counterintuitive. I don't usually search by tags, but you let me know what you think about that down in the comments below. And last but not least, iPadOS 26 brings the phone app to the iPad. Yes, you'll be able to get a real dialer to be able to make and receive phone calls. Now, it's not quite sure how this is gonna work when you have a cellular iPad. Do you get to, I mean, I really don't know how it's going to work, so I can't tell you how it's going to work, but I'm going to figure that all out by the time that the public beta comes out, so make sure that you are subscribed for that. Now, these aren't just new apps. They are meaningful upgrades that make the iPad feel like a complete productivity tool. Now, this next one is huge. Multitasking is getting a massive upgrade in iPadOS 26. Now, you can resize windows using your finger or the trackpad. There's no fixed layout, no set position, no size, no orientation. Doesn't like kind of snap into place. It's completely freeform, and I'm not talking about the app freeform either. Window mode can be enabled by default in the settings, or you can just tap on the new control center toggle whenever you want to turn it on. And just like on the Mac, you control each window using the stoplight buttons in the top left-hand corner. Hover and tap, and you'll get options to move and resize or fill and arrange the windows. And you can finally resize the Settings app. 2025, the Settings app, you can do it actually. Now, the number of windows that can be opened at once, it really depends on which device you have. It seems like right now it's at least 4, and once you go past that limit, it's going to be first in, first out. So as a new window is added, the oldest one drops out. Now, to view everything that you have open at once, you just swipe up on the trackpad. Exposé will reveal all the active multitasking windows, and if you swipe over to the right, you'll see all the full screen apps that are running in the background. Next, slide over, it's gone as well. No more weird floating window that gets in the way. You don't know how to get it out of the corner there. This new method that we're using is cleaner, smarter, and finally feels like a proper multitasking system on the iPad. But here's the kicker. Apps can now continue tasks in the background. You want to start uploading a video, exporting, rendering something, a 3D model. iPadOS will keep it running even as you switch apps. You'll get a live activity style notification while it's working and with a progress bar that shows once the task finishes. Now, iPadOS 26 is not just a list of features. It is a signal that Apple is finally giving the iPad a real identity because it has struggled for a long time with an identity crisis. You get multitasking windows, new apps, and small design details that make the whole iPad experience feel way more intentional. But here's what I wanna know from you. Is iPadOS 26 powerful enough to become your full-time machine? Why or why not? And if you could add just one feature by calling Craig Federighi on FaceTime saying, hey Craig, I need you to add this, what would that feature be? Let me know down in the comments below. Drop your answers, I'll be reading them, and I'll probably be stealing your best ideas for my next video. My name is Mike, and I'm out of here.